This time of year, I get the same question a lot because I have this habit of abbreviating Christmas as Xmas. And so people are like, wait a minute, are you trying to X Christ out of Christmas? Why don't you go ahead and put Jesus right back in there? It seems so un-American and un-Christian of you to say Xmas. Well, let me explain why I'm not only comfortable with using Xmas, but why I actually prefer to use Xmas. It all comes from a couple Greek things. The first is a Greek word that you may or may not be familiar with. And by the way, my Greek handwriting is terrible. A, because my handwriting is terrible. And B, because I never took Greek, and so I always have to figure out how to write these letters. And so forgive me if I mispronounce things and write it poorly. Don't send me email. I get it. I know that I do. So anyway, here is the first word that I think everybody needs to know. And again, I'm gonna end up writing it probably a little bit wrong. That one goes like that. That one goes like that. That one gets one of those. It's like something like that. Okay, so this is the word Christos. It is from Jesus Christ. It's the Christ part of Jesus Christ in the language Greek in which the New Testament was written. So if you look at the very first even chapter of Matthew, which is the very first book in the New Testament, which is written in Greek, if you go to Matthew, I guess I could have been a little bit more prepared knowing that I only have 4 minutes, but Matthew 1... Jeez. Matthew 1, verse 1, it says, the book of the genealogy of Jesus Christ. Okay, so that word right there, Christ, is that word Christos. So this X right here is the first letter of Christ. And so it's perfect to fit into Christmas. It's actually a great abbreviation. Actually, a better abbreviation would be X-T-M-A-S if you want to get picky. And the only person who gets that one right is Xtina Aguilera, who uses this abbreviation as well and doesn't get weirded out by it when she does it. So anyway, so this is Christos, and it's the first reason why I'm comfortable with using Xmas. The second is an icon that you may be familiar with because you've probably seen it around. It's an icon that looks... Oh, crud, I'm terrible at drawing as well. Let's try this again. It looks something like this. Have you seen this like on the back of people's cars and stuff like that? Well, if you pay close attention in a lot of those little fishies, you'll see a bunch of letters. You'll see an I, you'll see an X, you'll see one of those things. I'll explain that in a second, and a couple of those. This actually means Ichthus. It's a first century abbreviation representing Jesus. The I is the Greek letter iota, and it's the first letter in the name Jesus in Greek. And X, of course, we also know already from up here, that's Chi. So you would actually say iota Chi instead of JC. So if you want to say, yo, I'm down with JC, you'd say, yo, I'm down with iota Chi. So that's that. This little thing is theta. It represents God. This Y is epsilon, which is, it comes from the word sun, and that is a sigma representing Savior. So the first century Christians and people who put it on their car today, they may not even realize what they're trying to say is Jesus Christ, who is God, the Son of God, and our Savior. And you'll notice in both of these, we have this X representing Christ. And this is why I'm not only comfortable with this, I actually really like it when we use this right here for Christmas, because people will say, are you taking the Christ out of Christmas? And I get a chance to explain, no, we're keeping Jesus Christ in Christmas. He's the meaning for the season. So anyway, Merry Christmas, or Merry Xmas as the case may be.